Dr. Scholz, can you talk to me about Cyberknife? I see this Googled constantly. I know what it is, but I don't think a lot of patients understand the difference between Cyberknife and maybe other forms of radiation.
It is a type of beam radiation. We think of radiation as injectable radiation or seed implant radiation or beam radiation. The beam radiations are like IMRT, SBRT, proton therapy, and Cyberknife. Cyberknife is the trade name for a type of beam therapy that's given very rapidly. Many people that have been through radiation have been on a process where they go in daily for 5 weeks or 8 weeks. And those extended time periods were designed to reduce side effects, just a little bit of treatment each day. The Cyberknife folks, they were the forerunners of giving the treatment more quickly. Maybe in 1 day or 2 days. And to do that, you have to give a much bigger dose, and that dose has to be delivered extremely accurately. So as the forerunners of that technology, that trade name Cyberknife was developed. Subsequently, other beam radiation companies developed something called stereotactic body radiation, SBRT. And that's the same idea of giving a lot of radiation very quickly, perhaps in a few days or a week or two. The differences between giving the radiation quickly and slowly are that if you miss a big dose going in the wrong place, can cause a lot of serious side effects. So Cyberknife is very precise to avoid that. And in the prostate world, we worry about damage to the rectum and to the bladder. And of course, there's been other technological developments like spacer to push the rectum out of the radiation field. So Cyberknife is a nice technology that allows you to get very effective radiation over a short period of time.
So side effect-wise, in comparison to other forms of radiation, can you speak to that?
Yeah, it shouldn't be any different than other modern types of radiation like proton therapy, IMRT, SBRT. It's more dependent on the skill of the team and the physician that is designing the fields. The equipment is able to deliver very accurate treatment, but there is variation from center to center in terms of the skill of the physicians. This is always the case in prostate cancer. When you're selecting treatment, you have to think not only of what you want to do, but who you want to select to do it.
Talking about somebody who has experience and, you know, it really depends on who's doing it, how does a patient go into an office and ask, do they ask how many procedures they've done? What are the right questions a patient should look for?
Well, this is a perennial problem with prostate cancer, is figuring out who is really good at what they say they're doing. The best resources, I think, are perhaps support groups in the area, where you have multiple patients that have gone to these different centers and can describe their personal outcomes. So they're a good resource. The referring physicians who originally sent you to that doctor, if a urologist referred you to a radiation therapist for Cyberknife, you can ask that urologist, how many patients have you sent? How have the outcomes been? The assumption, of course, is that he's had a good experience or he wouldn't be sending people there, but it's usually a word of mouth type thing.
I always thought Cyberknife was such an interesting name because most people think it's surgery. It's this really cool, from the futurist, very futuristic surgery name. But
yeah, it's well named. The original experience I had first exposed to this technology, because it goes back a couple of decades, was for treating brain tumors. So as an alternative to doing neurosurgery, they were able to radiate these tumors in the brain with great precision and spare people from neurosurgery.
So Dr. Scholz, you mentioned support groups. If you would like more information about how to find a support group near you, our website has that information for you. So you can visit PCRI.org and just go to our services, and under that listing is support groups. It's a really great resource. You can just click on your state and find one. Thank you so much for watching this video. As you know, we are here for you, so you can go ahead and visit us at PCRI.org and get in contact with us. Please subscribe to our videos so that you can get more content like this, and give us a thumbs up if you like the questions. And if you have a question you would like me to ask Dr. Scholz or any of our experts in the future, you can leave it in the comment section below. We hope you have a great week. We love you very much. See you later.